Welcome back. The prime accused in Russian rape case John Fernandez finally surrendered before crime branch on Wednesday. Later, he was formally arrested. John's counsel has said John was not absconding, but police could not trace him during these 21 days.
John Fernandez surrendered before crime branch on Wednesday. John submitted himself to crime branch office at Donapol at 2 p.m. on Wednesday. John's counsel said he was waiting for the Supreme Court's verdict over bail plea. That's why he didn't surrender.
He took long time to surrender because his application was pending before the Supreme Court and it was fixed for hearing on the 4th. So we were waiting for the outcome of that hearing. So once that was the Supreme Court declined to interfere with the order of the High Court, we decided to surrender him.
Goa police were looking out for John from 16th of December. John's counsel maintained that his client wasn't absconding.
Absconding would be after all legal process was over. If he had not been available to the police, then he could be declared absconder. But when legal process is on and the police cannot find him, that would not be sufficient to hold him an absconder. To be an absconder, there should be nothing before the court. The court should not be seized of any matter and still he should be not found by the police. Then he could be declared an absconder, not otherwise.
DYSP of Crime Branch, Chandrakant Salgaonkar, said interrogation of John will reveal the truth. He is confident of giving this case a logical conclusion.
Investigation is to be carried out into the allegations against him and evidence has to be collected. The offence was taken place 1 month back, 2 months back, you know. The scientific method of investigation will prove the case against him.
So are you going to take any scientific help from...
Definitely. We have no names before us that these people are responsible for hiding. You see, let us see what he is telling in the intro disclosing in the interrogation. Definitely.
So all those
then that is there harboring somebody who is involved in the crime. And if that is come under the purview of IPC, we will apply. That's the same section also.
A reporter from Panji, Laukik Shilkar, with video journalist Ravindra Dalvi.
Contract workers of SEG have demanded reinstatement of 14 sect contract workers and regularize them. Kumbharjuwa MLA Madkaikar has alleged that sports minister wants to recruit his own men in these vacancies. Madkaikar warned these workers will agitate in front of residences of sports minister and chief minister in Madgaon from Thursday.
Pandurang Madkaikar has supported the aggrieved contract workers. He questioned why sports minister excluded 14 employees when they were recommended by an executive engineer.
He ji order tenchani tanka terminate karpai kadla ti 4 tarkher order kadla ani tenchat ja burghyang kadla tya ja sectionan kaam kari tya section headan tanka recommendation note dillo asa recommendation tanka note dillo asa va note 31 december ak mhanje ja disa tanka ja दिसा ही ऑर्डर टर्मिनेशन आयली तेज्या चार दिसा पयली आयज तेंचो सेक्शनल हेड जो एग्जिक्यूटिव इंजिनियर कलवाडेकर हेणी तेंका रिकमेंडेशन जो नोट दिल्लो आसा ते 14 भुरग्यांक कुंभारजुवा मतदारसंघातले आनी हांव स्पोर्ट्स मिनिस्टर लायतना हांव स्पोर्ट्स मिनिस्टर आसतना लायिल्ले कामाक ह्या मनशाचेर हेजी मनशाची बुद्धी भ्रश्ट जाल्ली अशें म्हाका दिसता कारण खंयचोच मिनिस्टर इतको निर्दयपणे अशा भुरग्यांचेर पोटाचेर पांय दिवंक शकना.
मडकयकार सॅड they would be shifting their agitation to sports minister and chief minister's residence in Madgaon from Thursday.
Palanchan ami sports minister cha ghara Madgaon vachan bastale chief minister cha ghara Madgaon vachan bastale ani amche va jo agitation asa he chalut davartale.
Opposition leader Manohar Parrikar criticized on the ongoing tussle.
Ya sarkaran kashe talla de paya tyat sarkaracho amdar ata to pahili jo mantri tane ghetlel lokang ata to sports minister ang kaad udayta. ह्याच सरकारान घेतल्या लोकांक हेल्थान काढून उडयल्ले आसा हेल्थांतल्या मनशांक काडले म्हणून हो मिनिस्टर स्पोर्ट्सांतल्या मनशांक काडटा आनी आपले मनीस घालतलो म्हणून सांगता आनी मुख्यमंत्री हे हेल्पलेसली पळयता पॅट्स हांकां कशे पिडल्या केवळ पयशे खावपाक येना तांकां नोकरी कन्फर्म करता करपाक हे तुमी सगळ्यांनी पळयल्ले आसा म्हणजे नोकऱ्यो पयशे दिवन दिवप आपल्या मनशाक दिवप हाज्या पलीकडे आतां वचपाक लागले फाटल्या मनशान एम्प्लॉय केलो म्हणजे कोणाचोय आसूं ताका काडप आनी आपलो मनीस घालप.
अ रिपोर्टर फ्रॉम पणजी लौकिक शिलकार विथ व्हिडिओ जर्नलिस्ट रविंद्र दळवी फॉर प्रुडंट मिडिया.
The Legislators Forum claims the bill proposed by the government to segregate uniform civil code might break the uniformity of law. Secretary of the Forum, Herculano Dorado, said that the Forum will deliberate on the proposed amendments.
The Legislators Forum will be celebrating Legislators Day on 9 January. The Forum will deliberate on many current issues. Government's proposed bill on the Uniform Civil Code will be the main issue for discussion.
One of the most famous law that we have is the Goa Civil Code, you know, that has come from Portuguese time. So that is very important for the welfare of our society, because it brings uniformity and cohesiveness amongst all communities. It's the same civil law for all Muslims, Hindus, Christians. But some time back, government had proposed a bill for segregating that, splitting up the laws of the code and go into separate laws. Now, that was felt bad because that would promote inroads into this uniformity of the law.
The Legislators Committee was formed after Goa got liberated. Every year, the members of the Forum celebrate the Legislators' Day.
We have also taken up on discussions on Regional Plan 2010 for the benefit of the members, plus all the municipal council areas which were otherwise not covered in that regional plan discussions that they went around. So our activities are continuous, and this year's program also includes elections of the new committee for the next triennium. Yeah.
Our reporter in Panaji, Devdas Kamli, with video journalist Ravindra Dalvi.
Let's take a short break. Stay tuned.